What's going on, everybody? Welcome to Fitness Informant's YouTube channel, fitnessinformant.com. I'm your favorite FI personality, and really the only FI personality, founder, CEO, Ryan Buck. I want to thank you for stopping by to check out 100% honest, no bullshit review of Performax Labs HyperMax pre-workout. Let me just say this before I start. Performax Labs might be one of the most underrated companies in the sports nutrition space. Their products are always done right. There are a few things here and there that can be improved, but the overall effectiveness of these products is solid based on what they're telling you you're going to get. That's the same thing with HyperMax. And today we're going to talk about HyperMax on five different categories. First, the ingredient profile. What's in this pre-workout? And then secondly, we're going to talk about the effectiveness. Third, we're going to talk about flavor. Fourth, mixability, as well as show you a mixability test here on camera. And then finally, we're going to talk about the value of this product. So let's dive into the ingredient profile. First, we start with Extreme Pumps and Performance Matrix, which is 6,000 or 6 grams of L-citrulline. Pure citrulline should be dosed between 3 and 5 grams. This is above that. What that does is helps regulate and enhance blood flow into your muscles, which is going to help improve the pump, which is going to help with muscle repair. Awesome dosage there. 3,000 milligrams or 3 grams of beta-alanine. Now, beta-alanine is clinically dosed between 3 and 5 grams. You'll see a lot of people say 3 to 2. Between 3 and 5 is fine. Beta-alanine, besides the little itch that it gives you, actually helps with performance output and endurance, so it's a solid dosage of BA. We're fans of that. Agmatine sulfate at 1 gram. Agmatine sulfate can help reduce the, reduce the engine in the body that tells your body not to produce nitric oxide in the easiest way. So it allows your body to produce more nitric oxide. It also can mess with your pain receptors, meaning like you can actually do 1 or 2 more reps without the failure because you necessarily don't feel the pain, but it's not enough to the point where you're going to go and injure yourself. Just another side effect of that. 1 gram of agmatine sulfate is a great dosage of agmatine. It's really typical. We are seeing more companies start to do more of it now, but TBD if that's going to work. And then you have L-ornithine, L-aspartate at 1 gram as well. This is gonna help with performance and blood flow. So it fits in there well. It's a nice ingredient. A lot of companies don't use ornithine. I actually like to see it in products, and it's nice to see it here. Now, you don't expect a ton of pump ingredients. Like, you don't expect to see Glycer Pump, even though Performax makes a product like that. You don't see a Vaso 6 or a nitrosigine. So keep that in mind when we talk about pump here in a little bit. Extreme Focus and Mood starts with 400 milligrams of PEA. PEA is known as your happy molecule. It really makes you like, it's the love molecule. As soon as you take it, you feel great. Your dopamine hits you and you're ready to go. The problem is the half-life is anywhere between 10 and 20 minutes, which means this wears off at 50%. So basically, it's only 50% effective at about 10 minutes, and it loses its complete effectiveness between, I would say, about 20 and 40 minutes. It completely wears off. So as soon as you take this and gets in your body, you need to go, 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 because you're going to lose it pretty quick if you don't. Urea Girensis extract at 200 milligrams. This is going to be a euphoric feeling from your eye. It's actually a really good stimulant. It's a very good exotic stim, as some might call it, to help improve mental clarity and focus and make you feel good in the gym. And then you have 50 milligrams, which is standardized to hortidine. Hortidine is going to help, a couple of things. Actually, hortidine is more of like a fat-burning supplement, so this could actually be down in the extreme energy blend. I think these next two ingredients should be switched on the label, personally. Hortidine is a stimulant, a fat burner. It's going to help produce energy. The next ingredient, which is an extreme energy blend, is L-tyrosine at 1 gram. Now, tyrosine is a cognitive-enhancing ingredient, so I think their label might be wrong. They should probably flip those two, in my opinion, and I'll talk to them about that. So L-tyrosine at 1 gram, that helps with mental clarity and focus in the gym. Caffeine anhydrose, 325 milligrams of caffeine. It's a big dosage of caffeine. Along with that 50 milligrams of hortidine, you got a ton of energy already. On top of that, you get 50 milligrams of synephrine, bitter orange extract. Another stim. These three, hortidine, synephrine, and caffeine, work awesome together to give you really good energy. You don't need much more than this, people. You're going to be stimmed out from the three of these. But they do give you 3 milligrams of basically Ralalpha. I'm not even going to pronounce it, but it's standardized to 90% rolocine, which is very similar to yohimbine. So it's about 2.7 milligrams of yohimbine-like ingredients, which is going to some people, really give you some crazy-ass energy. So as you can see, the profile is good on this. I would have talked to him with the label, but I think that it does three things very well. It hits on focus, awesome. Hits on energy, awesome. And I'd say pump is okay. Now, in terms of strength output and endurance, they had beta-alanine, it had ornithine, but it's not really, it doesn't have betaine, it doesn't have taurine, it didn't have like a pico-2. So, but again, they're not promising you guys huge endurance outputs and strength gains. They're promising you great mental clarity and focus, energy, and pumps, which is exactly what you're getting with this product. In terms of effectiveness, I basically just hit on it. Pumps could be better if you had like a glycerol monostrate powder in there to help keep the water in your muscles, or maybe even another nitric oxide producer like a Vaso 6 or a nitrosigine. But at the end of the day, this is a pre-workout, not a pump powder, so you don't necessarily expect it. Energy and Focus, top two, really good on this. If that's what you're looking for in the gym, this is really good. If StimMax from Performax is too much, this might just be right for you, because StimMax is way off the Richter scale, and I loved it. But this is going to be more for somebody who doesn't want to get that crazy cracked out energy in the gym. So it's overall effective in terms of energy, focus, and pump is there. Strength and endurance, you know, you got to use the caffeine to kind of carry you through. In terms of taste on this one, we actually were able to try orange mango. I'm a huge fan of orange mango. I was just kind of disappointed by this one. It just didn't taste as good. It was tart, but it wasn't the best tasting orange mango that I've ever had. So that's my only knock on it. I know they have other flavors, and being an orange guy, I had high expectations. So I was let down by it. It's not terrible by any means, guys and girls. It still tastes okay. It's just not what I expected. It didn't taste orangey. It didn't taste mangoey. It was more tart and kind of an off taste. So, you know, it is what it is. Taste is super subjective. You know, you guys can figure that part out for yourself. Mixability. Here's a video on mixability. You can see it. Really, pre-workout, 6 to 8 ounces of water is what I take it in, because I like to chug it before the gym. We're going to do it here for you on camera. I actually put a scoop of this. It comes from a baggie because we finished the container and we just had it in the baggie here to show you the mixability. But you'll see after a couple of shakes of the cup and pouring the glass, mixability is okay. You know, it's not off the Richter scale awesome, amazing, but it's not like in Death Valley shit either, right? So it has particles. It has some residue on the bottom of the cup. You may have to wash it down a little bit with some water. But if you just shake it up quickly and before it even gets a chance to settle, you chug it, you'll be just fine. In terms of value, this retails, it's 25 servings for $40. You know, I would like to see this at 30 servings for $40, actually, to be honest with you, but I think that it's a good pre-workout. I just think there's so many pre-workouts on the market now that are priced all around the world. You're seeing a lot of 20 servings now for $40. This is a 25 serving for $40, but the 20 servings for $40 sometimes have a little bit more in it. So I think it's priced fair. It's not like crazy bad pricing at all. I just think that it depends on what your goal is in the gym. If your goal is energy and focus, this is going to provide it. And at $40, it's not bad. Here's the deal. We actually have a coupon code here below, hopefully to save you a few dollars, and a purchase link. That way you're not paying the full retail price on this product to help you save a few dollars, because who doesn't love to save money? So check below for the coupon code and the purchase link. Make sure you follow us on all our social media channels. We're on Facebook, Instagram, Snapchat, and Twitter. Subscribe to our podcast. We are on iTunes, Spotify, Google Podcast, right here at YouTube. And speaking of YouTube, subscribe to our YouTube channel by clicking on the red subscribe now button here below. Stay up to date with all new Performax Labs reviews, all new pre-workout reviews, workout routines, etc., and podcasts. And for all things FI related, which is some awesome, awesome stuff, check out our official website. We're online, fitnessinformant.com.